Hi and welcome to a new series of Thinking Tackle. We're at Eastbourne Pier and we're going to try something a bit different. We like bringing you different ideas about fishing when we're doing these programs, and today we're going to try and use some carp bite alarms on the edge of the pier to see whether or not we can get them to work. So keep watching. Right, we're outside on the fishing deck, and as you can probably see and hear, it is absolutely blowing a hoolie. We've got a lovely rough sea. There's my rod out there now. There's the bite alarm. Now that's fixed to a Parker Twin Pro Rail Rest, which you can actually buy ready made for about £10. Absolutely blowing a hoolie, as I said earlier, and I've got no bobbins on the line at all. You don't want bobbins on when you're fishing like this, because they'll be forever going off. I've got my sensitivity set on the alarm to its highest setting at the moment, and you're getting the odd beep, but it's not going beep 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 all the time, which is good. And reel wise, I've just got a fixed spool reel with a bait runner facility, or free spool, whatever you want to call it. And that free spool is switched on. So if something does pick the lead off and charge off, then it can take line no problem. Which is the worst sort of conditions for fishing, for sensitivity and stuff like that. And if it was any worse than this, you probably wouldn't fish. But it's a great time to check out these bite alarms to see if we can get them to work. So we've got to give it a go. Just got a two-hook rig out there at the moment, which is slung out towards Beachy Head, which is over there, about 40 yards away from the pier. And we're going to see if we can get a bite on them. Now the plan is that if these do actually work, then maybe to fish on the beach at night, fish up a cod. With two alarms, you can actually get a remote receiver so it goes in your pocket. So no one will hear you've got a bite apart from you, with your little sounder box in your pocket, not disturbing anyone. A little beep there, but it is blowing 40 mile an hour. Expect the odd beep. But we'll see how they fish and whether or not we can get a positive indication and a fish for you. So I'm fishing at 90 degrees from me rod, so I'm fishing round to the right there, and the plan is that if I get a pull round, get an indication on the alarm, and if I get a knockback I should get one as well. So try them out, and we'll fish into darkness as well. No need for any rod tip lights, we hope, because the alarm should do the stuff. It's something a little bit different. There'll be many people out there be thinking that I'm mad, but we have the technology these days in fishing, so so why stare at a rod tip all night long if you haven't got to? nearly dark. It looks brighter on camera because we've got the filter set for night time, but you can see there's two rods on that system now. One of the pier regulars has put his rod on there to see if we've got double the chance. But no bites at the moment. So we'll keep fishing. Had a beep on my alarm. Line went slack. And we got a nice Dover sole. In stormy conditions with a bite alarm. Well, it's really turned even more windy and rainy than it was before. We had one bite on the alarm, produced a Dover sole, so we're going to come back either tomorrow or the day after. But for this first session, everything seemed okay. The alarm worked, we caught a sole, so we'll give it another go later on in the week. So here we are, we're back again on the pier. We've done some preliminary tests with the bite alarms. I'm now going to use it the way that I would do if we were fishing for cod. I've got a pulley panel rig on, fired out as far as I can get it. Tightened into the lead, so there's a bit of a curve in my rod there. And I've added a carp style bobbin, which is just there, which is tight underneath the rod blank there. So if I get a slack line, the weight of that bobbin will just drop sound off the alarm. I'll just demonstrate that to you. So we get a slack line. There's the indication. That should signify that something's picked the bait up, moved me lead, and hopefully a nice big fish on. Could be a lump of weed hit your line or something like that, or someone cast over you, but we're going to give it a go. It's the last day of the month, as I said. See if we can catch a codlin. Well, there's another white in, but no knockback, not big enough to move that lead. So we'll have another cast. It's about 11:30 now, we're at high tide. We have to move up a couple of steps because the water's starting to come through the bottom deck. We've had three white in, one bass, and a smoothhound pup, but as yet we've not had a big drop back bite, which is what we're looking for. So if it doesn't happen tonight, we'll come back and we'll do it all again beginning of October. We've got half an hour away now from October, so that means I've got a good excuse to come out tomorrow night. Well, finally, I've got a knockback bite. Rod tip went slack, bobbin dropped down, alarm went off, and I've got a 38 or 39 centimetre bass, which is going to be dinner for tomorrow. Very happy bunny. Yeah, 38 centimetre bass on the bite alarm. Happy days. Well, my session's coming to a close now, and I think that I have proved that you can get carp bite alarms to work in the sea. But, you know, what benefit are we going to get out of them? So the first thing that I can think of is that you've got an audio alarm as well as a visual. If you fish tight up and your lead gets taken out, you're going to get a big drop back. So in them winter months when it's freezing cold on the beach and you're tucked up somewhere, you can have a little sounder box in your pocket and you can know that you've got yourself a nice big bite without staring at your rod tips all night long. And then you've got the other things, because most of the other bite alarms that are on the market you have on your rod, and they're fixed on your rod, and sometimes you can cast and they get wrapped round the end, or your bells fall off, or your tip lights don't work. You don't need any tip lights with these. So I'm going to persevere this winter and try and catch some cod when there's some big fish about, where these alarms should come into their own. But I hope I've given you a bit of food for thought, and I look forward to seeing you on a beach or on the bank somewhere soon.